friends, and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Pelumi Agbola, as always, and thanks so much for joining me. If it's your first time joining me on this channel, please kindly click the subscribe button. I put up fun and amazing stuff. It's still our month of independence, as I'm wearing our Nigerian jersey. Happy Independence Day, Nigeria. Even though it has passed, we're still in the month of October, so happy Independence Day, Nigeria. But today's topic is what I've captioned: do I have gifted hands? Do I have gifted hands? There's this TV ad I used to run a while back during the Olympics. The TV was like a narration that was read by the American actor Morgan Freeman. It goes thus, try to remember it. There are 6 billion of us. We all come from unique places with unique ways of looking at the world. We do not always agree, but for a few weeks, we set this all aside. We come together to laugh, to cheer, to celebrate as one. That's a beautiful poem. But the part I want to focus on is the beginning, where it says there are 6 billion of us. We come from unique places with unique ways of looking at the world. So if there are 6 billion of us and we are all unique and different, we all have unique gifts and abilities as well. But the issue now is, am I doing the right thing for me? Like, how am I sure I'm maximizing all the gifts that God has given me? How do I harness my potential? How do I do this? If you notice, I'm not generic in all my videos. I give different opinions. And my own is not what you hear. Things like, what do people say about you? What can you do for hours without pay? What do people say you're good at? I don't do that. The thing I would advise you to do straight up is, number one, ask God. God is the one who created us, and since He created us, He will have a plan and purpose for us. Just like the manufacturer of an iron, he puts an owner's manual so that you know that, okay, this is a steam iron for ironing and straightening out clothes. So if you do not read the owner's manual, you may be confused as to what the iron is for, and probably if you don't know what an iron is anyway. But He is the one who created us, so it's pretty much logical just to ask Him. And how do we ask Him? We pray. That is the number one step I would advise you. Pray, because the truth is, we all have gifted hands, but it's just knowing what our gifts and talents are, so we do not laze about and spend futile years in a career path or doing a project that we're not meant to do. After praying, then we don't now pray and now relax and say, oh, I prayed, cross your leg, God is going to take care of it. No, don't do that. So after you've prayed, it's not left to you to use your human brain. Your brain is capable of reading the whole encyclopedia from cover to cover and memorizing everything, and you've not even done like 10% of this in the whole encyclopedia. So use your brain, be sensitive, like sensitive to your environment, pick up new interests, pick up new flares, and who knows, from there you might get your career path. Who knows, God also works in mysterious. We might get a dream, might hear a voice, but in case you don't now laze about and waste and chill for God to talk to you. If He talks to you, fantastic. If He doesn't, just to keep it moving. Okay, after you found your amazing talent, after you found this thing that you love to do, what do you now do with it? Because you now find opportunities and ways to harness that gift of yours. There's a book that I used to see, I remember, I'm probably gonna get a book later. It says, talent is never enough. And I know what the book is telling you, that if you have a talent, don't just laze around on that talent or feel that you've accomplished the world, you're better than sliced bread because you found your talent. No, use that talent wisely. That's what I think it is. If you want to sing or become an opera, become a performing musician, or sing in the church choir or something like that, use your talent. That's why you need two other things with your talent: attitude and skill. Let me use the singing thing. It seems like we're in the singing spirit today. When everyone sing, all right, so come Petrus, you now go to and sing. Everybody should stand up before I sing. One forming attitude, be like, who is that? You need the right attitude. Like, please, can we stand before we sing the national anthem? I'm wearing Nigerian jersey. Please, can we stand as we sing the national anthem? That shows what? The right attitude. That shows what? Respect. People like, Elaine Logbon, he has sense. Those things matter. So when you have a talent, you're not proud, or you're portraying a very wrong attitude, people like, who is that one? What does he have? They just completed American Ghost Talent, and The Voice Nigeria will be has ended as well. Millions of people can sing. So if you think you're the first person to sing in this world, imagine a 12-year-old girl. When America's Got Talent, I was actually rooting for Kechi because she was a Nigerian, but that's by the way. So if you think you're the only person that can sing in the world, they will replace you. You are not indispensable in the singing industry. So all singers out there, you are not indispensable. If you have a singing talent, God won't just give you the perfect voice. You have to work on the voice. That is harnessing that talent to become a skill. You now need to develop that talent into what? Into a skill that you can what? Monetize. So do you have gifted hands? Yes, I have gifted hands. There's this book that was the bestseller by Ben Carson, Gifted Hands, and it told the story of his journey into the world of being a surgeon and how he was able to successfully separate Siamese twins and also hemispectrum. So there are a lot of things we can do. We need the right attitude and the right skill. With that, you can be the best you can be. So number one, pray to God. Number two, develop yourself. Like after you find yourself, after you pray, also be sensitive to the things around you. Then develop your talent into the right attitude, develop it into a skill. And my recommended test for today is Ben Carson's Gifted Hands. And you guys read that book, it was just awesome. I read it in JS3, grade 9, and it changed me. I won't lie, I'm experiencing it. It really changed me. It made me really want to discover my purpose. A black boy in Detroit, like who could have thought that he would do that much? But here he is now, a renowned neurosurgeon, successfully separated Siamese twins, exploiting the world of hemispectrum and various other successful surgeries that many people were so scared to undertake. Ben Carson's Gifted Hands, read that book. So that's it today. So the question, do I have gifted hands? Yes, you do. You have gifted hands. We all have gifted hands. We just need to discover what it is that makes us shine. And trust me, you shine, I shine, we all shine. Thank you so much for watching this video. That's the end of it. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much, guys. End it with a dab. Bye-bye.